Welcome back to my channel and welcome to another craft day. Well, we're back in the craft room today. We're going to be working on some bows. And we're going to be working on a specific kind of a bow. It seems that all the rage right now is to make wall hangings and swags. Now, swags can be tapered swags like the teardrop swag that I will show you. Or they can be a mailbox swag, something that's roundish and goes over. Or another way swags are used is for decorating at Christmas time, like a staircase. And not the swag itself, but the bow we're going to make. And we're going to make a couple of swag bows. There's a couple of things different with a swag bow. The swag bow was not as puffy out as some of the bows. They're spread out more than puffed out. And secondly, they almost always have a center loop, where a lot of the bows we make don't have center loops. I'm going to take you down. It'll be easier to explain what we're doing when I show you on the table. We're going to do two swag bowls today. One is going to be for a swag, okay? And the other will be for what a project I'll work on later, which is kind of like a door hanging. And it just uses a round piece, so you're going to make a swag that goes straight across the top. So let me take you down to the desk and I'll explain what I'm doing. But before we head down to the desk, make sure you hit that subscribe button and the bell, so that you get notified when we come out to do some crafts. Now let me get my things ready, and I'll be back in just a second. Okay, this is the teardrop swag. Now I'm not going to make a swag today. I'm just using this so you can see how we plan the bow and what the bow will look like. Okay, the first thing you want to do is to measure the top of your swag to see. Now this is 12 inches. I don't want it to be any bigger than that. It'll go off the edge of the swag. So I'm going to start with 6-inch loops. Six on each side will give me a 12-inch span. Okay, so I'm just going to put this away for now. Well, no, one more thing. The other thing with the swag is lots of times your tails are not attached to the swag. And that's what I'm going to do with this one. I'm measuring down to the bottom. And then I'm going to measure again. And cut. And I'm going to just dovetail the ends. Okay. Then I'm going to take a piece of wire. I found the middle. I'm going to pinch it. Add my wire. And I don't need this much wire. And I'm going to add the tails to my wreath. And I'm just going to use one of these and wrap it around. And that gives me plenty of tail that I can go back and you know, put them in a couple of different places. I'm not going to do that right now. Okay, so now we're going to put this down. And take out the easy bow. And we're going to go with making the wreath, the swag bow. Now with a swag bow, the loops keep getting bigger or smaller depending on how you're making it. When you make it on the easy bow, let me turn the words around so you're not looking at them upside down. When you make it on the easy bow, you start with the largest. So, and I'm not making necessarily a tail because I've already done that, but I am going to just leave a little bit here so I have something to put my zip tie around. Okay, so I'm going to go on, I'm going to turn it, and I'm going out to 6 inches. And I'm just going to undo a lot of this ribbon here. Makes it easier to work with. Going out to 6 inches. I'm going down in. I'm going to twist it. And I'm going out to 6 inches. Okay, now I'm going to twist it. Let me see if I can bring you in just a little closer. So you kind of get a, there you go. I'm going 6 inches, but I'm going to go into 5. So I'm going to get this out of the way. And I'm going to 5 inches. Going down, twist it, going to 5, coming up, down, twist it. We're going to make 3 at 5 inches. So this one I just will go down and measure with the one I just made. Twist it. And then I will have a phone call. Hold on. That's all right. My husband picked it up. Okay, so we're on the other side. I'm measuring with the loop I just made. Okay. Twist it. And one more. The 5, twist it, one more at the 5, twist it. Now I'm going to do 4, and you really can't move too many of these out of the way, so I'm just going to come in like an inch on this one I've just made. And you can see here I've left about an inch. And we'll do two on this one. Twist it. Twist it. Okay. Now, I think I can get a 3-incher. Let's do 1 of 3 inches. Okay. twist it. Another one. Twist it. Now I'm going to make the center loop. And all I do with that is I go right over my fingers. And leave it like so. Now, let's get a zip tie. So I am going to cut this off. Going down under the whole thing. And up around. Now I'm just going to hold this tightly. Bring it to the back. Get my wire. Which I should have had out before I started. Put the wire in and tighten this down nice and tight. Okay, so now we're going to fluff. Now the first thing you want to do is to bring that center one up. And get that nice and rounded. And I can go back now and trim this a little bit more. So now I'm just going to take them two fingers in, two fingers in. The next one is two of them, so I'm going to go one this way, one that way. Two fingers in, two fingers in. One this way, one that way. And the next one is two. Actually three, sorry. Here we are. And then the last one, you can put it up the top if you like it. Or you can bring it out to the side. This is the two longest ones. And you can see that this goes sideways. More than all around in a circle. Okay? So that when you put it on your wreath, your swag, There you go. So here is the finished swag bow, and then you can take these and put them where you'd like. I'm not going to tie them in right now, but they'd be going something like this. Okay? There you go. So the difference between these and some of the others is that each row of loops is a different size. Okay, so that is for the swag. Let me get this out of the way and I'll be right back. Okay, the second one we're making is one that will fit on something like this round wood thing. And I started by making a little bit of a flower swag. And this time we're going to start the bow from the top instead of the bottom. Okay. I'm going to make a circle to make my center loop. Okay. Now I am going to twist it just once. And I'm going to go out and bring it in. And I'm going to go up and bring it in. And these two should be pretty much the same. See? Now I'm going to go out and I'm going to go a little bit bigger. Bring it in and twist, pinch. And I'm going to go up this way. Make it a little bit bigger. Bring it in a pinch. Now this is a smaller swag because it's a smaller area. So I think I can get one more. So I'm going to go up and one a little bit bigger. Bring it in and pinch. And I'm coming down. Now I am going to pinch that and leave a little bit. So have my swag bow that's going side to side, see? Okay, now I'm going to cut, let's do not too long. Maybe like so. And I'm going to one twist up here so that both sides are good. And I'll put that right in here also. Now I'll get my zip tie. And this zip tie is going to go around these, through this loop, making sure I catch this piece. That's the hardest thing you have to remember. Catch that little piece you started with. Get in there. is going to go just like so. And you see how each loop is bigger than the one before. I have a little piece of wire here, which would be plenty. I'm just going to go through, go around. And I detached my, I didn't catch my tail, so easy to fix. You just pinch it up, bring them down, see if I have another little piece of wire. I do. Here we go. Actually, don't think I'm going to have a tail on this when I do the sign. But there you go. That's the side by side. I guess you'd call that a side by side. Yeah, you know what? I don't like the tail on there. For what I'm going to be doing, this is more what I need. Like this. Perfect. So those are the two swag bows. They're easy. If you start at the top, you start small and get bigger. If you start at the bottom, you start big and get smaller. And I'll get a couple of pictures of these and show you how they look. Be right back. Okay, here's the swag bow with the little circle. Don't mind the clip on the top. I just have it clipped on there right now because I'm not ready to permanently attach it. And it looks really cute. It just is... Just, it's a bow that spreads out so it covers territory. And there is the swag bow that's on a swag. Let's see if we just spread this out a little bit. Here we go. Isn't that pretty? They're awfully pretty bows. The other thing you do with these is put them on the sides of your staircase at Christmas time if you make these kind of bows. And they hang down because they're flat on the back, so they go right up against this case. All right. Be right back. So there you go. Two swag bows. Both of them pretty in their own right. One done by hand and starting little and getting bigger. And one done on the bow maker, easy bow maker, starting big and getting smaller. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. And I will see you again on Friday. And we'll be doing something. I don't know. We'll think of something fun to do. Maybe something with this circle. And something that might go along with that ribbon. We'll see. Until then, everybody have a great afternoon. Play by the rules. Stay safe. And everybody play nice now. Love ya. See you later. Bye-bye.